Well, here's the task force. This is the organization. Yes, Mace. Mace Jasser, our newest committee member. So people who are well respected in the community, and I'm very, very honored to have met with and worked with many of them in the past, and actually many I've met and worked with in recent days. The mission and the vision of the SAC is basically to be recognized as a leading organization for the empowerment of Syrian Americans to promote educational, civic, economic, and human development, as well as supporting civil liberties and human dignity in Syria. Its mission is to mobilize Syrian Americans to strengthen civil society in Syria, to promote friendly relations between the Syrian and American peoples, to engage civic and governmental organizations to advance civil liberties and human dignity in Syria, and to encourage international cooperation based on international law and justice. Since the beginning of the tragedy and the heroic protests in Syria, we've had a chance to organize a first of its kind national meeting in DC, and we'll be hearing from one of the national board members on an update on it. Mahmoud Harmoush will be giving an update on that meeting, which was held on May 24th. But throughout, since that beginning of the protest, many members of the council and the chapters, so many chapters are formed nationwide now by people like yourself, trying to raise awareness about what is happening. Our main activism has been with media, trying to work, inform and pressure MSNBC, CNN, and others to cover the situation in Syria. So we've been sending them videos, we've been connecting them with people in Syria, human rights activists, or with people in the US who have family members in Syria, to make sure that the voice of the people of Syria is heard in America. Because we all know, unless people hear about what is happening, it doesn't happen. Unless it's on CNN, unfortunately, that means it didn't happen. So that has been one aspect. Also working with our friends in the local Arab media, and we've had great support from well-respected, of course, community newspapers such as Al-Arab, presented by Ustaz Muhammad Ta'kati, and Al-Watan, presented by Bassam Hadawi, who I saw entering a while ago. He's in the back. And others who have not made that decision to report freely and honestly about the situation in Syria. And we hope that their conscience will let them do that, and maybe a few phone calls from you would remind the other community newspapers to do the right thing. The other aspect was dealing with government. We've had a chance to meet with many members of Congress in DC and actually locally. Three of us actually had to do a lot of the tours, a lot of the visits to members of Congress and members of the Senate in the US to, again, raise awareness and demand pressure be put on the government of Syria to end the brutality against the people. What we're asking for is diplomatic and political pressure. We are not asking for any military intervention. We think the people in Syria are capable of setting the record straight.